What is going on, world? Steve Dab back once again with another episode. This is week number four, and I am pretty sure this is going to be the shortest video of this entire playlist that I'll end up uploading. So going into week four, I had just a lot of different moving pieces in the single family home investing side of things. So as a result, it occupied so much of my time. I really didn't have a ton of time to a ton of time to allocate towards mobile home investing, unfortunately. However, that doesn't mean I didn't do anything. I did manage to go ahead and get some bandit signs ordered. I decided to go with just blank yellow bandit signs, and then I'm going to build out a stencil, and then I'll just kind of spray paint the signs. It should, in theory, it should have a really professional look. But what'll happen is, as I begin working on them. Like, let's say if I get a few signs out and then for some reason I get a complaint with that number, then I'll just switch up the number. Currently, I am not using a call center or a call bot, whatever it's called, when you have like multiple numbers that you can purchase. I can't think of the name of one of them off the top of my head, but I'm currently not using one of those. What I am utilizing for the bandit signs is a Google Voice number. So I've got a cell phone just for my mobile home business, but I've also got a Google Voice number. One of the things that I've picked up, and I don't know if I've already mentioned this or not in one of the prior weeks, but one of the things I picked up is that if you're putting out bandit signs, be mindful of people calling and trying to get information from you, like your name, your company name, things like that. I've heard what can happen if the like ordinance, city ordinance police, whoever they are, if they get very annoyed by you. I heard that they can reach out and try to get information, and sometimes they may pose as being a potential buyer or seller or whatever your advertising is saying. So, it's one of those things. In the event that I do get a call like that, when someone tends to or seems to try to probe, I'll just inform them that I am outsourced call center. And basically I just take down information and then forward it on. So at least in my mind, that's what I think is going to happen. That's what I plan on doing. If that ever does come about, I will be sure to let you know. I think part of that comes from just making certain that like you don't want to make it, you don't want to put out so many bandit signs in the area that it looks like you're just littering the area. I mean, granted, yes, you want visibility, but like you don't want to be like you want to try to avoid placing them like on a park's property, definitely without their permission. I think if you are going to be placing bandit signs, it probably would be a good idea to kind of chat with the parks, just kind of see what their feeling is about it. And if they're not fond of having them close to their property, then just go down the street, place one near the closest intersection, maybe by a gas station or a stoplight, or places where people frequent, or where people maybe who live in that community may walk to or drive to on a regular basis, maybe near nearby grocery stores, things like that. So yeah, this the single family home project, I'll just kind of brief you on that. It really has nothing to do with the mobile home side of things. I guess nothing to do with it directly, but basically, I had a situation. I'm trying to get a few contractors in. I had a few people come in for bids this week. I had one person come in and the bid seemed decent. I'm really to the point where I want to be able to allocate more of my time towards starting this mobile home investing business. So the project that I'm currently working on, which is a pretty big project, and in fact, if you would like to see that project, I've got a like 3D virtual tour. Comment down below and I can hit you up with the link of that if you kind of want to just do a walkthrough so you can kind of see where the property is as of right now. But basically, I had someone come through and they gave me a decent quote and I was going to have them start, and I explained to them that, I have all my equipment, I have all my supplies, but I explained I don't pay contractors up front. But we can do like a series of four different draws or however they want to break it down. And as they complete, each segment of the agreed upon work, then I would go ahead and cash them out or whatever. So initially that was fine. They were supposed to start the next morning. Contractor calls me the next morning. He's like, "Hey, my guys don't want to work unless they have cash first." To which I responded, "So your guys want to be paid for not doing any work at all?" So needless to say, I ended up having a couple other contractors come back. I'm waiting to get their bids back, which should be in this weekend. But that's one thing I will say. If you have a contractor, if you already know this, great. If you don't, if you have a contractor working on a piece of property, do not pay them up front. In my opinion, that is not the way to do business. If you get stiff, very difficult to find them and get your money back. If you stiff them, they can always put a lien on your property, right? It's not like you're going to pick up your house in terms of single family homes. Not like you're going to pick it up and move it. So anyways, this is the end of this video. I appreciate you staying here. I promised that I was going to upload a video each week. So this is it. Pretty short, straight to the point, and look forward to hopefully a more inclusive or more educational video next week. Thanks, and I'm out.